Can I use packages from distro repositories to do compute things with my Intel Arc GPU? In this video, I'll talk about packages you need to try and do these things from distro repos, as opposed to the Intel repo. And then I'll talk briefly about my experiences using these packages with Ubuntu 24.04, Linux Mint 22, Debian, and OpenSUSE Tumbleweed. So if you're looking for a preliminary guide on this topic, maybe put this video in your bookmarks. I hope to revisit this topic in the future when I can, because as I learned, things are continuing to change and develop on this front. In my guide on installing the OpenVINO implementation of Automatic 11/StableDiffusion on Intel Arc on Linux, I recommended creating a separate partition and Ubuntu instance because of Intel's out-of-tree packages. This was because I didn't know what effect those packages would have if the repository was abandoned or if their out-of-tree nature started causing system issues, which eventually happened, to me at least. With the advent of Ubuntu 24.04, these packages are now in the Ubuntu Universe repository and are starting to show up in first-party repos for other Linux distributions. Starting off with intel-compute-runtime, this package provides API support for OpenCL and some levelzero functionality. On Ubuntu and distributions derived from Ubuntu, you'll need two packages, libze-intel-gpu1 and intel-opencl-icd. On OpenSUSE Tumbleweed, things aren't as intuitive. You'll need libze-intel-gpu1 and intel-opencl, or intel-opencl-devel. Dev and devel packages, as I understand it, usually have extra headers included. To make sure the OpenCL tidbits work, you can install and run CL info on both distros. If the response is bare, you got some installing to do.
So if you're really in the weeds with all of this, you may wonder, didn't you just talk about level zero stuff in the Intel Compute Runtime section? And the answer is yes. And there's also the level zero loader. Notice the GPU portion of the previous package names. There's a package for Intel CPUs too. For instance, when I install Vlad Mandich's SD.next implementation of Automatic 11/StableDiffusion, the project script wouldn't complete the install without the level zero loader. I don't have an AMD CPU, so I'm not really sure what happens if you try using this stuff on a system with one.
Anyway, on Ubuntu, install both libze1 and libze-intel-gpu1, and on OpenSUSE, well, the names aren't too similar, so level-0 and or level-0-devel.
Next is GMMLIB, known as libigdgmm12 on both Ubuntu and OpenSUSE Tumbleweed. The package I'll be talking about here is libVPL, known as libVPL2, the sequel, in Ubuntu's Universe repo and OpenSUSE's first-party repo. The source package libVPL, and its downstream packages in various distro repositories, acts as a dispatcher. It forwards function calls between one VPL Intel GPU, this source package, seems to have had its name changed, or Intel MediaSDK, the next two source packages which I'll talk about in the next section.
In this portion of the video, I wanted to take a quick break from the technical talk and first, thank you for making it this far. If you're finding this video helpful, I'd really appreciate it if you could leave a like and consider subscribing. I make content about Linux, and right now I'm focusing on Intel Arc on Linux because there's so much to cover, but I'd like to cover other topics in the future. This is my first attempt at making a video like this, so if you have any questions or constructive feedback, please consider dropping a comment below. I'll consider all of your suggestions when I'm making an updated version of this video in the future. Lastly, I was approached by at least one viewer who asked about tipping. I've set up a Ko-fi page. It's a bit bare bones at the moment since I've been focused on producing this video, but I plan to add more to it soon. If you'd like to leave a tip and potentially pay for a coffee, you can find the link in the About section below, or on the Compelling Bytes channel page. Any support is greatly appreciated, and I thank you in advance for your generosity. Now, let's get back to talking about these packages.
There are two packages, intel-media-sdk for legacy devices and vpl-gpu-rt for contemporary products. On Ubuntu, intel-media-sdk is known as libmfx, and vpl-gpu-rt is known as libmfx-gen1.2. On OpenSUSE Tumbleweed, install both libmfx_gen and
libmfx-gen1_2 for VPL era support, or libmfx for MediaSDK era functionality. The cutoff, at least for desktop silicon, is Rocket Lake or newer for the VPL package, and intel-MediaSDK, if I understand correctly, covers everything back to Broadwell. Intel-Media-SDK can be used on newer chips, but is limited by its older nature, which also includes, on Intel's behalf, the acknowledgement of security issues on the Intel Media SDK page, which, sounds concerning. Finally, libVA, which is the source package name for the Video Acceleration API for Linux Runtime, or the runtime for what is known as VA API, or VAPI. Is it VAPI? I say VAPI. VAPI works as a sort of open source bridge, or common denominator, across the encoders from the major chip designing companies that's photo-etched into their respective silicon. With all of that said, the Intel Media SDK slash libmfx packages I just talked about relies on libVA. Assuming you're using the typical x86-64 PC with an Intel Arc GPU attached, on Ubuntu you would install libVA2, maybe libva-dev, which is a bit more comprehensive. And on OpenSUSE Tumbleweed, libva2, and maybe libva-devel. You can also just use va-driver-all, but I want to avoid bloat or something, and I also feel like an imposter if I use this all-encompassing package. If you're using any device with a quick-sync encoder, you can check if things are working by installing libva-utils on either Ubuntu or OpenSUSE, and run the command va-info. For Ubuntu-derived distros, especially those without built-in snap functionality, like Linux Mint and Tuxedo OS, these packages should work seamlessly in versions based on Ubuntu 24.04. On Linux Mint 22, which is the new version of Mint based on Ubuntu 24.04, I was unable to get the OpenVINO implementation of Automatic 11.11 web UI working, but got Cartwheel FFmpeg, I call it FFmpeg Cartwheel, to work with a bit of a hack. Not being a fan of snaps, but appreciating Ubuntu's stability, I went upstream and tried these packages on Debian. The last time I tested, these packages were available on Debian Unstable. While the packages cooperated and allowed the OpenVINO implementation of Automatic 11.11 in previous attempts of me trying to get things to work, more recent attempts resulted in a bricked Debian instance. Wait for these packages to be ready for Debian testing, or a stable point release in the coming months. On OpenSUSE Tumbleweed, I found all these packages, although with different names as you've seen throughout the video. Unfortunately, I couldn't get the OpenVINO implementation of Automatic 11.11 working on the Chameleon/Gecko/Lizard distro. I kinda have a hunch that the packages aren't being built with the right parameters enabled. Regardless, I hope this changes soon, because it would be great to use Arc for compute or whatever else on multiple rolling distros. I hope this guide helps you get the most out of your Intel Arc GPU on Linux. I've been working on seeing if I could get these packages on this list from a given distro's official or at least community-maintained repo for months, and everything came together at about the time of release of Ubuntu 24.04, but then things started falling apart. Alright, time to work on the next video. Until next time, take care.